My name is Dr. Sanjay Juneja, and this is Dr. Lauren Juneja. We're both medical oncologists and hematologists, and here we wanted to kind of talk about the basics of breast cancer. It's a cancer that a lot of women fear, and rightfully so. The incidence is pretty high, and it continues to get higher the older you get in life. But because of screening and mammograms that we recommend every year, the catch of this breast cancer is a lot earlier than it used to be, which is very important because that's when you're able to treat the breast cancer the best, is when it's the smallest, and hopefully when it's taken out, that's actually a long-term cure.
So generally for average risk women, which is the majority of women, we recommend routine mammograms yearly starting at the age of 40. However, some women choose to do mammograms every 2 years, and that actually is not against recommendations either.
It's true, and it's because of that screening where we can catch things early. Now, there's a lot of concern, right? It runs in my family. I hear it's genetic. And on the flip side, some people think, I don't have breast cancer in my family, I'm fine. The majority of breast cancer, by far, is not a genetic or inherited thing. It's something that happens in your lifetime because the older we get, the more mutations we get in a cell, and eventually some bad mutations can turn that into a cancer. But there are inherited disorders that we're having more increased awareness of and recognizing sooner, some most commonly being BRCA1 and BRCA2. And we're gonna talk all about all that later. But the biggest thing about breast cancer, and this is if it's not what's called DCIS. And DCIS, it's breast cancer, but it's not invasive. So it's something that some people consider precancer and others say it's invasive. It's a cancer that's still contained and generally is still taken out and radiation is usually given, but it's not the stage 1, 2, 3, or 4 breast cancer that we traditionally send for an oncologist for systemic therapy to treat. The most important thing about breast cancer by far that is very important for you to know is what's called the receptor status. And so there are 3 receptors. Hormone positive is a huge binary distinction. Is it hormone positive or is it not? And by hormone positive, we mean estrogen and estrogen receptors and progesterone receptors. And the reason that's important is generally those do better, and that's a general term, but more importantly, you can attack those estrogen and progesterone receptors with therapy. So if it likes to eat estrogen and progesterone to grow, then we block it. And that's why a lot of the treatments surrounding hormone positive breast cancer involve blocking floating estrogen hormone. Now the third receptor that's extremely important is called HER2-neu. It's a protein that we discovered was at first very bad. It was aggressive, it led to a very aggressive diagnosis of breast cancer. And if you're listening to this, you may say, oh my gosh, mine is HER2 positive. But by isolating that protein and seeing that mechanism, we now have drugs that attack it. And so it's completely flipped as far as how effective we are at being able to control HER2 positive tumors. So there's triple positive, where you could be all 3, and then there's triple negative. And triple negative is a little more stubborn in the sense that we don't have those targets to attack. And that's why it's very crucial to, if you're going for cure with a triple negative, you really want to have it just out. And we want to maximize that. And to do that, we have to use general cytotoxic chemotherapy. Why? Because we can't use targeted therapy if it doesn't have something to target.
An important point is these receptors should be tested on the initial biopsy that you have once you're found to have an abnormality on your mammogram.
Absolutely. And the second part of the receptor status, in addition to the size, and the second part, in addition to that receptor status and the size and how early it is, that's really gonna dictate which direction you go in your therapy and how high of a risk you have for it to come back, is the lymph node status. That is something that we use differently. This is the key. If you're a hormone positive, those lymph nodes mean something different on the treatment course than if you're a triple negative with positive lymph nodes when it comes to treatment planning. Do you need chemo first and then surgery? Do we do surgery first? All that is different depending on the receptor status. By lymph nodes, we mean basically the highway where the cancer jumps onto if it's trying to spread somewhere else. The initial assessment is just on clinical exam where you actually feel for lymph nodes in the underarms. But depending on what the circumstance is, you may get some additional imaging to see if those nodes look suspicious or that they may have cancer, to basically manage and have a plan for how you're going to handle your treatment. But overall, breast cancer is very scary, but there is a lot of attention, fortunately, on treating breast cancer. So if you are a stage 4 patient, which means that the cancer has left and spread somewhere else, just know that there are things and therapies that we can target to still have a very good quality of life, and sometimes for up to years, because we're identifying these targets. And as time goes on, if we're able to identify more, we can still hopefully have good control of the disease. And in this sequence, we're hoping to be able to teach you more specifically, not just what's happening, but why, so that you're more comfortable with your diagnosis. We know that cancer is such a scary diagnosis. What shouldn't be a part of that is not knowing what you're in for or really what's ahead. That's why we want to provide you with this educational content so at least you know what you're in for. My wife and I have seen it time and time again, the courage and strength that comes out of people when they know what they're in for. And that's what we want to provide you with. We're thinking about you. You guys really do inspire us when it does affect you and your family. And we hope you get a lot of value from this series.